Good day, viewers. Welcome back to my channel. As always, we'll be continuing the H6 series today with an episode about the buttons around the steering wheel as well as on the console. So let's jump right in. Enjoy. And before we even get to the buttons, I want to show you this. You have two outlets there, the top one being a USB out. Let me show you that. And the bottom one is a 12 volt outlet. Important to note about the top one, this one here, is the top one is a USB power. It's not for data sending, which means it will not communicate to your in-car entertainment system. That is this one on the left. That one will communicate to your Android Auto, and that one only, the left one. So let's talk about the system. I've turned the car on now, as I want to just focus on these buttons for a moment. What I appreciate about these buttons is the fact that while you are busy doing something, even when you are on your Android Auto or whatever, if you are on the Android Auto, these buttons will override it. So, for instance, if you feel, I need to get the air on, if you press that button, it will turn on the air immediately without asking you for any other inputs, okay? If that is off, okay, and it will go to the air system, and then it will exit by itself, okay? So even when the system is, the HVAC system is off, if you press aircon, the aircon will go on with the HVAC system, and you will be in air conditioning mode, okay? As mentioned before, if you tap on auto, it will put your air conditioning system in full power until you switch it off. That's just something to note. You see, if you press aircon again, it will go back in again. That's that, okay? That's those two, okay? That's those two. This one, you see, these two are different. This one has a curvature. Why? The curvature of this one indicates the curvature of the front windscreen. This one is always the defogger of the back window, and this one is always the demister for the front window. And that is also split from the demister, because that one there belongs to the aircon unit, because it's part of HVAC. Because if you press that one, it will immediately turn on the demister for the front window, which is related to your air conditioner or dependent on your air conditioner. Okay, so that one is front and it's curved. This one is the rear window demister. However, there's a trick to it. It's also connected to your rear view mirrors. Your rear view mirrors are heated. So what happens is, when you turn on the demister, it will turn on the heated rear view mirrors as well, which will assist in getting rid of dampness, iciness, and just the rain on your mirrors. So if it's bad, it's misty outside, it's rainy, you get into the car, you've been parked outside, or you are driving but you can't see anything in the mirrors, switch that one on. It will clear the mirrors up. Really nifty trick, that one. This one, I believe you all know, it's for the camera system. And this one here will turn the system off. Okay, so what this button does is it turns the complete system off. Okay, what I want to show you, I just want to give some volume here. If you turn that off, the system will be off. Okay, so my hint here is, however, when you are outside, you are busy, you are, let's say you are washing the car, you will notice that the system keeps connecting to your Bluetooth device. Every time you open the door, it will connect to your Bluetooth device, which sometimes can be really frustrating. So when you park the car outside and you know you're going to be busy now, do this. Bluetooth off. Turn off display. Again, display off. Display off will kill the system so that it doesn't display anything. Now the system is dead. Now you can continue in peace and it won't bother you. All right. Okay. Next up. Okay, guys. This one is interesting. You also note there in that little cubbyhole, I have sticked some of that non-slip carpeting because I like to throw a remote control in there that I need and it won't rattle. It won't rattle, it won't make a noise at all. It will just be quiet. Okay, so now. This button, when the doors are here, unlocked, this button will open the boot. You can also stop it and close it again. Okay, that's that one. This button here, when your headlights are on main beam, you will be able to focus the beam of the headlights from low to high. There's 0 and 1, 2 and 3. So you will be able to adjust the beam, the angle of the high beam, of the main beam. So maybe try that. You'll see it makes quite a difference. Okay. This one is to turn the car's traction control or ESP mode on or off. That will turn the ESP mode on or off. Together with that, I want to show you something here as well. Let me just do that again. With display, with the ESP mode off, it will show you there that the ESP is off. But when you turn it on, there's another function here. When you have turned it on, it will also keep the dynamic stability assist off. You need to turn that one on separately. Okay. Guys, this one I have explained in the shortcuts video. Please just have a look at that video contained within the playlist. Okay, guys, this one is quite simple. It's the downhill assist function. So when you are moving down a very steep slope, yes, this is not a 4x4 vehicle. It's not meant to be an off-road vehicle. However, you might find yourself in a situation where you need to drive down something where it seems very steep. Just turn that on. Point the nose of the car into the direction where you want to go. And just let off the brake. Keep your foot on the brake. It will brake the car and keep the car moving at a very slow pace down the hill. You won't have to worry about it. You just cover your foot over the brakes and it will brake the car itself as it moves slowly down the steep slope. That's it. Okay, now for the buttons around the steering wheel. This will be the best way to film this one. Okay, guys, this is the right-hand stalk. This is for the window wipers, okay? What I want to show you here is you select the wiper modes like this, okay? 1, 2, 3, okay? And then when it's off, those will be these ones that we've just went through, okay? So top is mist and it will return to off, then auto, then low, then high. So what I like to do is push it up all the way and let go, and then one down, then you are in auto. So this will turn the wipers on and off as the car seat fits. It will select between fine rain and heavy rain. It will increase or decrease the intensity of the wiper speed while the wipers are in auto mode. Okay, this one is for the rear window wiper. Okay, it has three functions. Okay, first of all, when it's off, you can go to from off, spray and wipe, back to off. Spray and wipe, back to off. It is spring loaded, that one. So when you leave the button, it will go back to off. Okay. Second one will be on. While the wipe is on, you can go to spray and wipe, back to on. Spray and wipe, back to on. And then back to off. Okay. When you pull it towards you, it will spray and wipe the front window. Spray and wipe the front window. As long as you keep it pulled, it will spray. Also, interesting, the car just done something there that I wanted to show you. Okay. When you pull and hold on the wiper stalk, it will put the wipers into service mode, which will pull the wipers upwards and keep them there. Okay, this will allow you to open up the wipers if you want to wash the windscreen or do anything here. Okay, maybe clean down here also. So that will assist you with that. And then to get that system turned off, all you do is turn the car on. Okay, the light switch stalk. Okay, first of all, this is your main control. Parking lights. Main beam on, auto. Okay, so that's parking, main beam, that's your driving at night lights, or auto. Then the car will decide for itself. I just leave it in auto, guys. It makes my life a lot easier when it's in auto. When you drive through a beach, it will turn the lights on and off, things like that, or tunnels and whatever. But gets dark, it will turn it on. However, it will not turn the lights on when it's raining. Then you need to do that. I wish they want to just connect the wipers and the lights to each other so that vehicles can know that when the wipers are on during driving, the lights must go on automatically. I think that'll be a good system. Okay. Then when your car's lights are on, okay, you have these three here. These are spotlights and mist light at the back. Okay, spotlights are now off. Okay, what I love about it is when you put this car's spotlights on, it's not spring loaded, it stays there forever. Some cars are like this. You see, this one is spring loaded. So when you put the spotlights on, it will go back, and then you'll, every time you switch the lights on, you must turn on the spotlights. I love it that this one is on. So when you do this and you do that, your spotlights will go on with your headlights every time automatically. I love it. Okay, so this is front spotlights. Okay, you can turn it on and off. I have a video specifically speaking about the spotlights and what they can do. If you haven't seen that video in the playlist, please have a look at that. Okay, so that's spotlights. Okay, now, after the spotlights, when it's misty, you'll take it and do that, and that will turn on the mist light at the back, in the center of the car at the back, a very sharp red light. Okay, the very sharp light at the rear. So, guys, that's not a light for driving. Please don't drive with that light on permanently. Please, it's a very sharp light. It's inconvenient for people following you. That is for days when it's misty outside and it's raining heavily. Obviously, right hand indicator light, left hand indicator light. Also, when you just want to change lanes, it flashes three times. use this. I mean, it's, you are putting wear on the stroke to do this every time you want to change lanes. Just go like this, change your lane. Go like that, change your lane. It will switch off automatically. Okay? This is how you flash someone. Where you put your lights on brights, your main beam, with the lights on, you put it there. Then your main beam will be on. Let me show you here. When you go there, you can see the lights indicating. This one is to show that the lights are on. This one is to show that the front lights are on. When you push it back, it will show your I-beam is on. When you pull it towards you, it will show you are flashing. Okay? Let me just find a way to show you this. Have a look at the indicator lights there. What it does when you turn on the spotlights. See, it shows that little light there. That's for the spotlights. When you turn on the rear mist light, it will be a yellow light. It will look like that. Okay. Spots, mist light. I leave my spots on. I just love driving with it on. So you'll see here, even with a mist light on at the back, you can turn the spotlights on and off. The only way to turn the mist light off again is you need to go and do that, or you can go and turn the lights off and back on. Okay, that's that. Okay guys, that's it for the lights switch. I'm running out of light here rapidly, so what I want to quickly do is quickly show you and speak to you about the cruise control system. I have discussed this system in a previous video in the playlist. Please just have a look. I just want to show you here. When you turn on the cruise control system, when you are driving, that will turn the system on. Okay? As I've indicated to you, it will show you there. It will be faded out. If it shows like that, and this one there shows up, that little car there with a arrow on the speedometer, that means your cruise control is on. I won't be able to activate it now because I'm in park, okay? But that's how you switch it on. So one pull, it's on, okay? Now you're driving. When you get to a speed that you want to cruise at, downwards, that's it. You are set. You are ready to go. You take your foot off the accelerator and you are now cruising. If you do this and keep it in, you will be accelerating. You'll see there, it will show you there your speed. When you leave it, it will stay at that speed. When you do this, it will decelerate. Okay? You can now cruise. When you touch the brake, it will automatically disengage immediately. Or you can just do this, cancel. That is cancel. Another one is turn the system off. So, on, off. Okay? Set, resume. Okay, set, let me explain resume. Set is now you have set the system at the speed. But let's say you had to brake for a truck or whatever. When you want to go back, let's assume that your set speed is 100 k's an hour. When you want to go back to 100 k's an hour, you don't need to accelerate to there and set it again. You just do this, resume. It will go back to 100 k's an hour. Even if you are at 40, it will go back to 100 automatically when you press on resume. Okay? And then cancel, off. So, this one, you'll see there it shows a little car, and I can show you. It shows a little car here. When you press down and up on it, I'm going to press up on it now. You see it increases or decreases the following distance between the two cars. That's how you will set your following distance between the car in front of you and yourself. Very easy. If you feel you are too close to that car, you'll just go to up, push it up, and it will increase. When you think now I want to be a little bit closer, you'll go down. That's it, guys. That's simply how easy it is. Guys, in today's video, I'm not going to discuss the steering wheel buttons. I think that we have discussed it in previous videos.
Hi viewers, that will be it for today's video.
I hope you have enjoyed the video and I hope that you've learned something. Please consider subscribing to my channel if this is the kind of content that you enjoy watching. There will be a host more to come. And then, until the next video, take care, stay safe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.